two of the most distinctive marks of the holiday season of gathering for Christmas are the giving of gifts and the singing of carols. And I believe both of them are rooted in the same need, the need to express ourselves when words themselves just aren't quite enough. We need more than just what words can do. Singing and giving allow us to say more and express more when our souls are full to the overflowing. Giving of gifts, like, let's think about how gifts are usually given throughout the year. If you think about all the events at which gifts are given, birthdays, anniversaries, weddings, graduations, baby showers, how does that work, right? One person or one couple receives all the gifts, right? And if you go to a baby shower, it tends to be everyone politely eating cake and watching one couple open or one. This is what happened when Olivia and I were at a baby shower. We opened gifts while people ate cake and watched us, right? And that's what it tends to be. Or at birthdays, one person opens gifts and everyone else kind of eats cake and watches them. That's not how it is at Christmas. At Christmas, it's not one person getting gifts and everyone like just piling on with one person getting all the gifts of everyone else piling on. At Christmas, everybody gets gifts, right? And I don't know how gift giving goes and receiving goes for y'all on Christmas morning. But let's just say for the Coons, if you don't pay attention, you very well might miss something. Because everyone gets a round of gifts, and they're all open, and we look around, you pay attention, and now it's time for the next round. It's kind of a beautifully overwhelming experience. Is that the polite way of putting it? It is the giving and receiving of gifts that is like no other point during the year. The saint who helps us practice, who first sort of connects the birth of Jesus with Christmas is Saint Nick, Bishop Nicholas of Myra. And I love the way that he gives. When he gives, he doesn't just give to one daughter in this family he helps. He gives to all the daughters. He doesn't give just a little bit of what they need because they need money for dowries. He doesn't give a little bit of silver. He gives gold and lots of it, like that sort of extravagant giving to everyone. That's been part of the Christmas tradition for centuries, right? And so Christmas not only transforms for one day a year how we give gifts, it also changes how we sing. Right? We know that when we sing, there's a power there to what we say. If I say to you, I love you, well, that's nice, Andy, I love you too. If you sing a love song, right, there's more punch to that, isn't there? Right? There's a reason that love songs just keep on being made, because we want to express something that the spoken word by itself just can't quite capture. And so we know that's how it works, and yet we tend to get very self-conscious about singing. I know this because I watch a lot of people not sing Sunday after Sunday, right? Because that's what I do. I stand up here and I announce the hymn, and I know who jumps in and sings, and I know who doesn't. And there's one time a year when everyone sings. It doesn't, the rest of the year, there are certain people who would never sing all year round. But you announce, now let us sing, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, and everyone just opens their mouths, and it is amazing, right? At Christmas, churches sound amazing as people sing with an enthusiasm that just simply doesn't happen at any other time of the year. The first gift of Christmas is celebrated as Jesus is born, the angels sing, and it is this combination of gift and song, the gift of the Messiah who will offer salvation and forgiveness and hope to all who follow him. And it is such amazing news that it inspires this joyous giving and singing every year. So I want to invite you to approach these next couple days with a distinctly joyous approach to all of this. I invite you over these coming days, don't just eat with the people you're going to be gathered with. Feast.
right? And I'm not quite sure, what is the difference between eating with people and feasting with people? It's the joy that you bring to it, right? You're just genuinely excited. I get to eat with these people, and it's just great, right? So don't just eat, feast. Don't just hang out with family, but pay attention to family. Pay attention to them so that you're spending this amazing time together, giving of yourselves. And my final invitation is in these coming days, when you hear Christmas carols, don't just mumble along. Can I invite you to please just sing? Just sing. And I want to give you a time to practice right now. So stand up. Come on, stand up. You know this one. Let's sing.